Hi, this is Manos Brilakis from the Minneapolis Heart Institute and the Cardiovascular Innovations Foundation, presenting case 154 for the Manual of CTO Interventions. I am grateful to Drs. Judith Karakshany and Imre Ungi from Szeged University in Hungary, who kindly allowed me to use this phenomenal case in the Manual of CTO Intervention series. This case, I think, is particularly instructive as it illustrates the potentially catastrophic complications that can happen during retrograde CTO PCI. The patient had a previous anterior ST elevation myocardial infarction that was treated with a 2.5 by 28 and 2.75 by 15 millimeter drug-eluting stent, and also had a right coronary CTO that was attempted at a different center a few months prior to the current attempt. These are the angiograms from the initial attempt to cross the CTO. There is a blunt proximal cap with a small branch at the proximal cap, diffusely diseased distal vessel. During undergrade wiring attempts, the wire went into the small branch, and eventually there was a dissection in the proximal vessel, and actually a drug-eluting stent was placed, extending with the dissection extending further down into the vessel. So the CTO PCI attempt was aborted, and the patient returns now 4 months later for a repeat CTO PCI attempt. There is still some residual dissection of the proximal cap. The length of the occlusion is short, about 15 millimeters. Distal vessel has some disease, and there are septal as well as epicardial collaterals. The plan here was for undergrade crossing, followed by undergrade dissection reentry if it didn't work, followed by a retrograde attempt. Undergrade wiring with the Filder XT, followed by a Gaia second and Gaia third. The wire clearly has moved into the subintimal space, and there's actually quite some distance between the false lumen and the distal true lumen. Same for the ultimate Bros 3 guide wire. A cross Bos was also used, but it just did track through the same course of the guide wire. And then one of the complications of ADR that can make things difficult is hematoma formation in the subintimal space. We can already see here that there is distal vessel compression, likely from subintimal hematoma. So that was what was done very astutely, is to place a balloon more proximally inflated, and that can prevent expansion of the hematoma. Another option is to use a guide extension, as was done lately. Subsequently, a stingray balloon was advanced, but again, we do have extensive distal hematoma, and re-entry was challenging. Despite multiple attempts using the stick and swab technique, we can see that re-entry was actually unsuccessful. Because of that, a decision was made to switch to retrograde crossing, and then eventually that could successfully cross the septal collaterals, and now we have an undergrade guide extension and a retrograde guide wire. Guide extension can significantly facilitate performance of the reverse cart. This is a retrograde Filder XTA. It was pulled back and redirected and eventually found its way into the undergrade guide catheter extension. So guide extension can truly minimize the length of tissue and occlusion that the retrograde wire has to cross to enter into the undergrade guide catheter. And then an RG3 guide wire was externalized, followed by stenting of the distal right coronary artery. Once again, contralateral injections are very important to visualize the bifurcation and allow for accurate placement of the stent. However, the patient at this point had a hemodynamic collapse and actually was started on CPR, and an injection of the left system revealed the cause, which was actually thrombosis within the previously placed LAD stent. If you recall, the previously placed stent was relatively small, 2.5, 2.75, and even though the ACT was 320 seconds, still thrombus formed within the LAD. What is critical for salvaging those cases, and was very nicely done, was having a safety wire inside the LAD. So in case of a complication as this one, we do have access to the distal vessel and treatment can be done, which in this particular case, it was with aspiration thrombectomy, which restored the undergrade flow and helped the patient stabilize. There is still some slow flow here in the diagonal branch. So eventually the RCA PCI was completed, but the patient had a repeat hemodynamic compromise And a repeat aspiration thrombectomy was performed into the LAD. We see now the diagonal has actually good flow to it. And there was post-dilatation of the previously placed LAD stents that might have been slightly undersized. The patient stabilized, and then a final nice result was achieved. There is good flow in both LAD and the diagonal. And there is also a good flow into the right coronary artery. He had an uneventful post-procedural course and was subsequently discharged from the hospital. This case illustrates one of the potentially catastrophic complications of CTOPCI, which is donor vessel occlusion or thrombosis, as in this case. One way to minimize this is to keep the activated clotting time high. So a common number for retrograde CTOPCI is to keep it more than 350 seconds, whereas for undergrade, 300 seconds is commonly used. Also, if there is any question for disease in the donor vessel, it is a good idea to perform intravascular imaging, and if needed, perform PCI in the donor vessel to minimize the risk of hemodynamic compromise reduction in undergrade flow during the retrograde portion of the procedure. Another potential cause of donor vessel closure is contrast injection causing dissection or deep engagement. And to minimize this, contrast injections should not be done if there is a dampening of the guide pressure. And after the guide wire is externalized, the donor vessel guide is typically disengaged and moved back into the aorta to minimize inadvertent movement into the vessel and causing dissections. So donor vessel closure is a potentially catastrophic complication. To minimize it, keep the ACT high, more than 350 seconds for retrograde procedures. Also, keep a safety wire in the donor vessel so that if a problem occurs, treatment can be easy to do. And then if there is donor vessel issues, thrombosis in this case, it was treated with thrombectomy. If it was dissection, then stenting might have been required. Thank you very much.